with lovers and friends. I still can recall some are dead and some are living.
Times we had together. it out there, can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end. And suddenly it's like women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us round? Will this memory stay when I leave this town? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking it's a time to fly.
Some good times. So take a good look around. You may Thank you. Thank you. Bonsoir à tous et à toutes. Good evening. Avant de commencer notre cérémonie ce soir, nous reconnaissons, respectons et honorons le territoire traditionnel des Premières Nations Tsawwassen et Musqueam et de toutes les populations parlant Ankaminum qui ont pris soin de cette terre depuis des temps immémoriaux.
Good evening, everyone. Before we begin this evening's ceremony, I would like to acknowledge that this is taking place on the traditional, ancestral, and unceded territory of the Tsawwassen, Pumusquam, and the Ankaminum-speaking people who have been here stewards of this land since time immemorial.
Bonsoir et bienvenue à la soirée des finissants de Burns U. Je m'appelle Madame Trinka et je vous présente Madame Stark et on sera vos hôtesses ce soir. En particulier, on aimera faire la bienvenue aux invités spéciales, les curateurs et curatrices de Delta, le surintendant adjoint de la commission scolaire, les parents, les familles, les amis et bien sûr, aux finissants et finissantes de la classe de 2022.
Hello, and welcome to Burns U's Valedictory Ceremony of 2022. I am Ms. Stark, this is Ms. Trinka, and we will be your hosts for this evening. In particular, I would like to welcome our special guests, our Delta School trustees, the assistant superintendent, as well as Burns U staff, parents, families, and of course, the graduating class of 2022.
Que tout le monde se lève pour l'hymne national, chanté par Kai Glass.
Please rise for our national anthem, which will be sung tonight by Kai Glass.
Hatred, love in all of us commend. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, our true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Merci, Kai. Je vous présente Monsieur Younger, directeur de Burns U, pour faire la bienvenue.
Thank you, Kai. And now I present Burns U's principal, Mr. Younger, who will with a welcome for all of you.
And yes, thank you, Kai. Good evening. I would like to take a few moments to welcome our graduates, parents, grandparents, other relatives and friends, and Burns U staff to our commencement ceremony. For many years, I've stood on this stage on graduation night and said essentially the same words to graduating students. These words, I hope, are filled with meaning, hope, pride, and joy. However, the past couple of years have been different, And as a class, your education experience has been like no other. Don't get me wrong, you are similar in many ways to other groups who have graduated while I've been a principal in Delta. Just like those classes, you are great young adults who love your school and your classmates. Just like other graduates, you are filled with promise and hope. Just like them, you are excited to enter the next phase of your life and ready to take on the world. Still, you are a class like no other, with experiences like no other. As I think of your class and your high school experience, what comes to mind is profound gratitude for you as a group and for this community and for the myriad of ways you have supported and guided one another. The students and families and the staff and me, and as we have sometimes stumbled and other times soared through these years. The past years have been challenging, to say the least, with the multitude of changes and trials we have all worked through, from moving to remote schooling following spring break of your grade 10 year, to the quarter system and greatly reduced academic expectations in grade 11, and on to grade 12, with a full return to school, only now with semesters and the gradual opening of more normal experiences, activities, and connections, all very different from pre-pandemic years. For many of us, these worlds have turned our world upside down. From the global pandemic, which has greatly altered many of the time-honored traditions of our staff and students, how we do school, remote learning, how we connect, to the nightly televised violence and atrocities perpetrated through the war in the Ukraine, to the awakening of our nation as we come to understand our own often hidden history and the institutionalized racism that has been carried out against Indigenous people and other identified groups. In isolation, any one of these events is a lot. For all of them to have happened in a mere 24 months is hard to fathom. We've all experienced the compounded impact of these events. Yet it's June, and here we are at graduation. We made it to the end of the school year, simultaneously exhausted and called to action. Now, before I jump into the typical graduation speech with words of wisdom and guidance, I want to reflect on hope and recognize that while our society has gone through much struggle, history shows us that such challenging times ultimately inspire cultural change, art, revolution, and a better future. We are now just beginning to understand how some of the effects of COVID-19, things like telemedicine, remote work, Zoom meetings, and social distancing will influence the future. How will this collective experience of the pandemic influence art, cultural, education, and society? About a year ago, I read an article by Adam Grant from the New York Times. And thank you, Dr. Tobin, for sharing this with me. The article was entitled, "There's a Name for the Blah You're Feeling," and it's called languishing. And it's about the lack of connection, motivation, and a general sense of apathy and numbness that so many of us were talking about and feeling. According to Grant, it wasn't burnout, we still had energy. It wasn't depression, we didn't feel hopeless per se. We just felt somewhat joyless and aimless. It turns out that there's a name for that, languishing. Languishing is a sense of stagnation and emptiness. It feels like you're muddling through your days, looking at your life through a foggy windshield, and it might be the dominant emotion of the pandemic. And that feeling, languishing, is what I keep coming back to and why I reference the spurts of growth, innovation, creativity, and societal change that have come out of past human challenges. Yes, many of us have felt this feeling over the last 24 months, but when I look into this crowd of graduates, I am again feeling hope, because I am confident that you will learn from this experience, that you will make human connections a priority again, that you will innovate and create and build, that you will make profound art and great music, that you will redefine what is possible as we emerge from a period that has felt impossible at times. And redevelopment of these human connections doesn't have to be big. Grads, start small. Instead of texting your friends funny TikToks, pick up the phone and call or meet up for lunch, take a walk and catch up with each other. Instead of studying alone next year, over screens, find people to sit with, talk to, learn with, be in the presence of other human beings, and bask in how joyful that is. Do things that make you happy and that fill you. Bake, sing, run, write, dance, learn a new hobby, or pick up an old one that you've forgotten that you love. And now for my abbreviated part of a traditional grad speech, I would like to share my final and perhaps most important advice. As you move out into the greater world, be sure to value yourself. Respect your own intelligence and intuition. Have faith in yourself. Be brave enough to chase your dreams, strong enough to bounce back if you get hurt, wise enough to admit your mistakes and learn from them. Know that each of you is unique, and therefore each of you brings to the human race something special that no one else can offer. Again, always remember that you matter and can make a difference. Live your life with integrity and dignity. Determine those beliefs you base your life on and who you are. Have the courage to be unwavering in the defense of those beliefs that are the root of your decisions. And before I close today, I have one request to make of you, and that is to thank somebody who has helped you through this year. Your teachers have worked extremely hard these past years. Thank them. Your friends checked on you, even when they may have had nothing left in the tank themselves. Thank them. And your families, well, they carried you, they carried their families on their backs and loved you despite their own exhaustion. So please, please, please thank them. My prayer for each of you is that you find fulfillment, peace, and happiness. I wish every one of you the contentment of a productive life, the respect of your fellow human beings, and the love of your family. You are the Burnsview class of 2022, grown up and graduating. We are proud of you. May the future be yours. Thank you.
Je vous présente M. Kanakis, curateur de Delta, pour présenter les salutations de la part de la commission scolaire de Delta.
I would like to welcome Mr. Kanakis, trustee of the Delta Board of Education.
It's my honor to be here tonight and represent the Delta School Board. Delta schools play a very important part in my life. As a former teacher and current school board trustee, I've seen firsthand the hard work and enthusiasm by our students, their families, and our staffs. It is a special honor to be here tonight for Burnsview's 2022 graduation. Graduates, you have worked hard, and this is a very important time in your life. Looking around this room, I can see the many people who've made this possible. We have your teachers, we have your family, and we have your friends. There are the teachers who have encouraged you and supported you. I would also like you to think back to those elementary school teachers, the ones that were holding your hands when you scraped your knee, helping you every day graduate through elementary school. Also, I'd like you to think about your high school teachers and all the time and effort they put in to getting you to this point where you are today. I'd also like you to think about the volunteers, the coaches, the sponsors, all the time that they've put in to get you to a point of graduation and turn you into the human being you are today. Think of your parents and your families and the sacrifices they've made to help you to get to this point in your life. Driving you to school, helping you with your lunches, doing your homework, or helping you with your homework, I should say. Could be. And supporting and loving you through everything, no matter what happened. And also remember your friends at school and friends who didn't have at school with you, who helped you with your homework, who supported you through 4 years of high school, and who have are here tonight to support you. I have a question for you. What's next in your life? Where are you going, and where will life lead you? That's a question that most grads are asking. And I'm just going to share a little story with you about my life. I was a typical high school student. My friends were going off in various directions at graduation. I decided I was going to go off to university, and that was my life path at that point in time. I had no real idea what I was going to do. Then one day, a friend of mine said, "You want to help me coach a football team?" And I thought, "Oh, okay, I can do that." And then I found that I really enjoyed working with kids. I enjoyed being with them, teaching them, helping them learn. And from that point in time, I went on to be a teacher, and I taught for 33 years at North Delta Senior Secondary School. I can honestly say that I had found my passion in life. I loved going to school every day and working with kids. But I had no intention when I was at university of even thinking about being a teacher. And grads, you're at a really important time in your life. Some of you are trying to decide what you're going to do. Others have their career path set. And you can follow those dreams, but you can also change your future. There's no real straight path from where you think you are right now to where you're going to be 5 or 10 years down the line. There's going to be changes. There's going to be stops, starts, zigs and zags in your education. You're going to go on possibly to further education. Although some of us think, "Oh, I'm done." No, we're not done. When we graduate from high school, we continue to learn. So don't worry about it. There's going to be surprises. There's going to be great opportunities. But be open to that change, because you have the support of the people in this room, and they will be with you no matter what happens. Grads, you are flexible, adaptable, and problem solvers. You have the opportunities and skills and the education of your generation. It's time to take that next step along the path of life. Walk with confidence, knowing that you are well prepared and supported in the next stage of your life. With that in mind, I urge you to find the passion in your life and follow it. So on behalf of the Delta Board of Education, I congratulate the grads of Burns U for 2022.
Je vous présente M. Bowman, surintendant adjoint, qui va offrir des paroles aux finissants.
I would now like to welcome Mr. Bowman, assistant superintendent, with an address to the graduates.
Well, thank you so much. It is just an absolute pleasure to be here, and good evening, everybody. Burnsview staff members, distinguished guests, parents, family members, elders, and of course, the graduates of 2022. I'm truly delighted to be here this evening to celebrate this momentous occasion with you all and bring greetings from the Delta School District senior leadership team. It is absolutely wonderful to be back in person. And as Mr. Younger so eloquently said, this is something that some of our previous grad classes didn't get the opportunity to do. It's so wonderful that we're able to do this at this time. As we gather here today, I want to acknowledge we're celebrating on the traditional territory of the Tsawwassen and Musqueam peoples, and I want to show honor and respect to the elders and all of those First Nations that have been stewards of this land since time immemorial. Class of 2022, you're way up there in the dark, you did it. We are here to honor and celebrate your hard work and accomplishments tonight and the successful completion of your high school education. To the parents and family members here this evening, I want to thank you on behalf of the district for your unconditional love and support that you've provided to your children over the years, and to thank you for allowing us and building that partnership with the Burnsview Secondary staff and for trusting the Delta School District each day with the education of your child. To Mr. Younger and the entire staff of Burnsview Secondary, thank you for your unwavering dedication and commitment to this impressive group of young people. It is through your steadfast commitment of teachers and support staff that we have got through the pandemic and allowed BC to be one of the most the least disrupted educational jurisdictions in the world. It's enabled schools all over the district to deliver the most face-to-face learning possible. The difference you have made is truly immeasurable. On behalf of our district team, thank you for all you do. And to the graduates, you're graduating in an era that has defined any notion of predictability. For many of you, the past 838 days since COVID-19 was declared a pandemic have involved navigating so many challenges, unique obstacles in both your personal life, your family life, and of course in your education. This pandemic has undoubtedly disrupted your way of life and created so much uncertainty for you. Despite this, I believe it's likely brought out some of your strengths as individuals. Each of you have had to develop resilience and adapt to new ways of engaging with your school and with your learning. You should be incredibly proud of all that you have accomplished. In recent years, you have also been bombarded with negative news and social media posts that paint a picture of a world on the verge of one crisis after another. However, I'm so heartened in working with the students of this district to see that so many young people are forging ahead with a bold sense of optimism and hope, and with a desire to drive transformational innovations and engage in incredible acts of human compassion. One thing that is clear to almost everyone I talk to is that the experiences of the pandemic have amplified the importance of human connection and relationships. Our care and compassion for each other has been what has allowed so many of us a way through these challenging times. As you enter the next chapter of your lives, I encourage you to hold your connections and relationships close and at the forefront. As our society moves down a path to greater automation and technology continues to be woven into the fabric of almost every aspect of our lives, do not lose sight of those qualities that are uniquely human. Connection and relationships will always matter. Go confidently, graduates, in remembering that you have within you the strength, the patience, and the courage to follow your passions, reach your goals, and thrive, no matter what challenges come your way. Burnsview Class of 2022, it is my honor to share this evening with you. Congratulations and very best wishes on your graduation and for continued success in the future. Thank you.
On vous présente M. Younger, qui va présenter la médaille académique du gouverneur général.
Mr. Younger will join us once again to present the Governor General's Academic Award.
Thank you. May I also please have Trustee Kanakis join me at the podium? I'll pass that on to you. In 1873, the Earl of Dufferin, who served as Canada's Governor General, created a medal to recognize scholastic achievements. Each year since 1873, the Governor General's Academic Medal is awarded to the student with the highest academic standing at their institution. This medal is always awarded in the year following graduation, as we wait and include the results of all examinations that the students have written. For our class of 2021, last year's grad class, the winner of the Governor General's Medal is Hargan Mojral. At this time, could I please have Hargan join us on the stage to receive the Governor General's Academic Medal. Can you stand beside Trustee Kanakis? Thanks, Hargan. Hargan graduated from Burnsview with an average of 98.4 over his grade 11 and 12 school years. We're still wondering about that 1.6%, by the way. Hargan attained this high standard while taking a very difficult academic course load and also while taking two concurrent studies courses at Kwantlen University. It should be noted that Hargan graduated a year early, but he still managed to be involved in both school, in the school and our community. Through his high school years, Hargan was involved in much volunteering, including environmental cleanup activities, running a blood drive to support the Lower Mainland Blood Bank, as well as many other community-based events. Please join me in recognizing Hargan for his accomplishments at Burnsview. Thanks, Hargan.
C'est avec grand plaisir qu'on vous présente les finissants et finissantes de la classe de 2022, ainsi que le certificat, bourse et prix. Je vous demande, s'il vous plaît, de garder vos applaudissements jusqu'à la fin de la liste. Je vous présente d'abord Mme Martinek, qui va commencer les présentations des premiers élèves.
And now it is with great pleasure that we present to you the graduates of the class of 2022, as well as the certificates, scholarships, and prizes. I ask you to please hold your applause until the end of the list. And now, Ms. Martinek will begin the presentation of the first students.
Mahmoud Abu Naboud. After graduation, Mahmoud is planning to take math and science classes and then apply to civil engineering program. He'd like to thank his family and teachers for their support. Mahmoud is the recipient of the Senior English Language Learners Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Well done, Mahmoud. Shaq Abu Naboud. After graduation, Shaq is planning to take ECE diploma and work towards her goal of being a kindergarten teacher. Arwa Adan. Arwa will be attending Simon Fraser University in the fall, studying chemistry. She'd like to thank all her haters for motivating her to succeed. Arwa is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Arwa is also the recipient of a $500 bursary from the Delta Youth Support Link Society. Here to present the scholarship is my bestie, Miss Abel. Arwa has also won the $500 Trevor Shurtiff Scholarship. Congratulations, Arwa.
We need a light.
Mariel Aguilar. Mariel is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual Dogwood diploma. Mariel's post-secondary plans are to continue her studies locally at Kwantlen Polytechnic University to explore the field of psychology and careers relating to it. She'd like to thank all her friends and family for encouraging her to pursue various opportunities. Mariel is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Mariel. Noor Al-Majarish. After graduation, Nora is going to spend the summer working to save money for college. She's going to study dental hygiene in November. Nora is also happy at Burnsview, and she'd like to thank her parents, teachers, and friends for their support. Lana Al-Gharib. Lana plans to continue her studies to be a practical nursing at Sprouts Shaw College. She would like to thank her parents with their constant support in her schooling and life and for helping her to shape her life with positivity and love. Lana would also like to thank all the teachers for their hard work. Abdullah Ali. Abdullah will be going to BCIT in the future. He'd like to thank his family and friends for motivating him. Abdullah is also the recipient of the Senior Technology Education Metalwork Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Congratulations. Aisha Ali. Aisha is receiving a dual Dagwood diploma in the French immersion program. She will be continuing her studies at Douglas College to pursue her dreams of becoming a teacher. Aisha would like to thank her council and her favorite teachers. They know who they are. Rishi Arora. Rishi will be attending Langara College in September for a bachelor's degree in business administration in business management and will also be acquiring his real estate license in which he will pursue a career. He'd like to thank his parents and brother for the guidance and support they have provided. Rishi is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done. Najimo Awale. Najima will be attending Douglas College in the fall to study social work. She believes that books would leave her alone, once again, that she graduated from high school, but still, 4 years to go. Nashtail Awale. Douglas College is where Awali has landed. Education is so important for her family, and she is pursuing a longtime interest in nursing degree. And as they say, with every hardship comes ease. Rishu Bega. So Rishu messed up his UBC application, so he will be studying at Simon Fraser University, where he will attempt to put his life on track and also try to become a neurosurgeon, just like his dad and Dr. Stephen Strange. He would like to take a full second to thank his parents, a millisecond to thank his homies, and a quarter of a second to thank Yami cumulatively for helping him get through his school years. Could this comment be any better? Rishu is the recipient for an outstanding achievement in academics as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. Rishu is also receiving a Senior Science Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Congratulations. Gerline Baines. Gerline is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual Dagwood diploma. After graduation, she will be attending the University of British Columbia in the Faculty of Science. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teacher for their support and encouragement. Gerline is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. Well done. Emily Bancroft. Emily is receiving a dual Dagwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending Toronto Metropolitan University to pursue a bachelor's degree in sports media, as well as continuing her softball career for the school. She would like to thank her brother for being the coolest and most encouraging person over the past 5 years. Emily, stay on stage for a while. You got a speech. Emily is recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as the Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. She is also receiving the Outstanding Scholar Award, which is presented to a student who has maintained an outstanding scholastic achievement through their Burnsview years. Congratulations, Boo. You got the Griffin Cup. Emily is the recipient of a $500 Burnsview PAC scholarship. Here to present this scholarship is Mr. Butler. Emily has also been selected to win the $750 Delta Principals and Vice Principals Association scholarship. And here to present that is our own vice principal, Mr. Richards. And last but not least, Emily, get back here. Emily is receiving, it is my absolute honor to present this to you, kiddo, $1,000 for excellence in innovation, leadership, and being a kick to the butt yearbook editor.
Gertej Baring. Gertej will be attending KPU for business. He would like to thank all of his friends and family for being so supportive, and he would like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Kugel for making English 12 his favorite course. Maria Basco. Maria is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She will be attending Douglas College for the veterinary program. Maria wishes to thank her family, friends, and teachers for all of their support throughout these 5 years of high school. Maria is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics, and Maria is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in community service. Congratulations, Maria. Milind Bihari. Milind is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. After graduation, Milind plans on continuing his education in business. He would like to further extend a big thank you to his friends, teachers, and especially his family, who have supported him throughout his life. Milind leaves us with, "Never settle for who you are." Aiden Benza. Aiden will be taking a year off school to work, play hockey, and travel. In the future, he will be pursuing a career in the field of kinesiology, hoping to help young athletes achieve their athletic goals. Kayla Burnaby. Kayla is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She plans to continue her studies at Douglas College in the kinesiology and sports science program. Kayla would like to thank her parents and friends for their support throughout high school and to the PE faculty for helping her find her love of fitness and athletics. Kayla is the recipient of the Senior Girls Physical and Health Education Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. And Kayla is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Kayla. Amanit Bander. Amanet is attending UVic this fall to eventually pursue a career in education. She has enjoyed her time at Burnsview and is grateful for all the memories made. She would like to thank all her teachers, especially Mrs. Kugel and Mr. Massey, for inspiring her to fight for what she believes in. Lastly, Amanet would like to thank her family for raising her to be a strong and kind person. Amanet is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Amanet. Carter Bolshin. Carter would like to thank his family and friends for their support over the years. Next year, he is planning to work until he decides which program to take at university or college. Mackenzie Bodkin. Mackenzie will be pursuing a career in psychology at Kwantlen Polytechnic University. Her future plans include travel. She would like to thank her family for all the love and her friends for being the casa she always wanted. Mackenzie is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a scholarship achievement award of distinction. Well done, Mackenzie. Rihanna Bratch. Rihanna is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending UBC next year for applied biology. Rihanna would like to give a special thanks to Ms. K for making law and social justice her favorite classes. And a special shout out to Ms. Bai for making her laugh at every school soccer game. Rihanna is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. She is also the recipient of the Outstanding Senior Female Athlete Award, which is given to a female athlete who demonstrates outstanding athletic ability, sportsmanship, and leadership. As well, Rihanna is the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Rihanna. Indevere Barr. Indevere will be continuing his studies at Thompson Rivers University studying architecture. He would like to thank his teachers for an amazing year at Burnsview. He would also like to thank his friends and family for their support throughout high school. Alexis Bray. Alexis is graduating for the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual Dogwood diploma. She plans to continue her studies at KPU in Health Sciences. Alexis would like to thank all of her friends and family for their support. She could not have done this without you guys. Alexis is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as the Senior French Immersion Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. In addition, Alexis is also the winner of the prestigious $40,000 BD Luminary Scholarship. Congratulations, Alexis! Sophie Bruchet. Sophie is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She plans to attend U of Vic in the fall for social sciences. She would like to thank her parents for always believing in her and her sister Amber for her constant help and support all throughout high school. Sophie is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Sophie is also the recipient of a $600 bursary from the Canadian Federation of University Women, North Delta Surrey Branch. Here to present is Ms. Samra. Congratulations, Sophie. Layla Bryan. Layla is graduating from the French Immersion Program and receiving a dual Dogwood diploma. After graduation, Layla is pursuing a career in nursing. She would like to thank her family and friends and give a special thanks to Ms. Bai and Ms. K. Chase Burrows. Chase is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual Dogwood diploma. After graduation, Chase will be attending LaSalle College Vancouver in the Game, Art, and Design program. Chase is the recipient of the Senior Boys Physical and Health Education Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. As well, Chase is also the recipient of a $500 scholarship from QP1091. Here to present this scholarship is QP1091 member, Mrs. Chang. Congratulations, Chase. Akelia Campbell. Akelia will be attending the University of Alberta in the fall, studying psychology to fulfill her dream to be a forensic psychologist. Akelia would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for supporting her throughout her years at Burnsview. I encourage you to live with life, be courageous and adventurous. Give us a tomorrow more than we deserve, which is a quote by Maya Angelou. Akelia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, and as well, Akelia is also receiving a $5,000 entrance scholarship from the University of Alberta. Congratulations, Akelia. The next presenter is Mr. Hume.
Alicia Chahal. Alicia is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She plans on attending business in the fall and eventually studying in England. Alicia would like to thank her family for everything they have done for her. She promises that when she becomes famous, she will try to remember you all. Erin Chuan. Erin is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies at Douglas College for computer programming, then transfer to SFU. Erin would like to thank his parents and friends for their continued support and his teachers for all their hard work. Erin is the recipient of a $250 scholarship from Tej Lab Technologies. Here to present this scholarship is the Community Programs Manager for Tej Labs, Nicole Salazar. Erin is also the winner of a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Applied Design Skills and Technology. Congratulations, Erin. Alexis Chouinard. Alexis is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University this fall, where she will be studying psychology. Alexis would like to thank her family and teachers for always supporting her. Faith DeMello. Faith is graduating a year early and will continue her education this fall at Queen's University. Faith is the recipient of a $1,000 bursary from Delta Youth Support Link Society. Here to present this scholarship is Miss Abel. Congratulations, Faith. Carter DeJare. Carter will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University studying horticulture with a goal of working in the cannabis industry. He would like to thank his family and teachers for their constant support throughout his time in high school. Ronan Delisle. Ronan is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He will be attending Douglas College in September. Ronan would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for their support and guidance. Yeah. Dia Dhaliwal. Dia is taking a gap year before continuing her studies in early childhood education. She would like to thank her family and friends. D is for Dia. Paramveer Dhaliwal. Paramveer plans to go to JIBC for the law enforcement course. His career goal is to become a police officer. Sam Diestro. Sam is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He plans on continuing his education at Douglas College in criminology. Sam is very thankful for the friendships and bonds he's created with students and teachers during his time at Burnsview. He would like to give a big thank you to his parents who sacrificed and supported him in every decision along the way. Sina Doling. Sina is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She plans to continue studying French at SFU. Sina would like to thank her parents, teachers, and her bench crew for supporting her through the ups and downs of high school. Sina is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. Sina is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in fine arts. Congratulations, Sina. Jacqueline Dunlop. After graduation, Jacqueline plans to travel for a year before continuing her education to become a teacher. She would like to thank her friends, teachers, and especially her parents who have supported her throughout the years. Jacqueline is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics, as well as the Senior Art Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Well done, Jacqueline. Vanessa Eagles. Vanessa is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She plans to study science at Kwantlen Polytechnic University. Vanessa would like to thank her mom and dad for their support and her sister for an enormous amount of positivity and guidance. Owen Erker. Owen is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He will be studying sports sciences and kinesiology next year. Owen would like to thank his friends and family, with a special thank you to Karen, Nathan, and Liam Erker for always being there. Owen is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. Well done, Owen. Leonardo Escobar Garduno. Leonardo would like to thank his family and friends for supporting him throughout the years. Without your guidance and compassion, he feels he wouldn't have gotten this far. Congratulations, grads of 2022. Jada Evans. Jada is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She'll be studying kinesiology at UBC in the fall. Jada would like to thank Mrs. Vita and the swim team for giving her something to look forward to each year. She wishes them the best of luck next year. Jada is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics, as well as the Senior Instrumental Music Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Jada is also the recipient of the Director's Award, which is presented to a student who has shown outstanding instrumental ability, dedication to the program, and who is a true inspiration to all musicians. And that's not all. As well, Jada is the winner of a $1,000 Delta Band bursary and a $500 Health Sciences Scholarship from Dr. Parmar. Here to present this scholarship is BurnsU alumni Dr. Gagan Parmar. Jada is also receiving a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Physical Activity. Congratulations, Jada. The next presenter is Madame Trinka.
Sam Galloway. Although Sam is sure his musical abilities will get him far in this world, he would be nothing without the help of his best friends and biggest fans, Alex, Ronan, Ananth, Nolan, and Owen. Their constant love and support has always meant the world to him, and he hopes they understand how much they have all meant to him over the years. Sam owes the biggest thanks, however, to his greatest inspiration in life, his mother, who has inspired strength in him in ways so big that he did not know how to fit them into a speech. He owes everything to these people, and he promises he won't forget any of you when he's famous. John Garness. John will be moving to Chilliwack to embark on a 2-year tattoo apprenticeship program. He would like to thank his father for his support in showing him the way. Love you, Mom and Dad. Harneet Gill. Harneet will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University in the fall, studying criminology. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for their constant support throughout her years at BurnsU. Harneet would also like to wish her peers all the best in their future endeavors. Suhana Gill. Suhana is an early graduate who will be attending post-secondary in the fall, where she will be studying business. Suhana would like to thank her parents, teachers, and God for their support throughout this adventure and for helping her get to where she is today. Suhana is receiving a Gold School Service Award for her commitment to helping within the BurnsU community. Suhana is also the recipient of a $725 scholarship from Canwell Caterers and Compass Canada. Here to present the scholarship is Ms. Bai. Congratulations, Suhana. Sirkov Gill. Sirkov will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University in the fall, studying psychology. He would like to thank his parents and close ones for their constant love throughout the years. Kai Glass. Kai is graduating from the French Immersion Program and is receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She'll be continuing to pursue her passion for fine arts at the University of Victoria and would like to thank her parents as well as her theater family for all of the cherished memories. Kai is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. She's also receiving the Senior Drama Award and the Senior English Award, which are given to a student who demonstrates outstanding ability in these focus areas. As well, Kai is receiving a $700 scholarship from Artona. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Stark. Kai is also the recipient of a $1,000 Delta Teachers Association scholarship. Here to present the scholarship is Allison Roach, first vice president of the Delta Teachers Association. Congratulations, Kai. Veerkesh Gulab. Birkesh is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He plans to continue his studies at UNBC, where he will be studying biology to achieve his dream of becoming a zoologist. He would like to thank his teachers, friends, and especially his parents for helping him get to where he is today. Deirdre Grant. Deirdre is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. Next year, she'll be taking some time off before attending post-secondary. Deirdre would like to thank Madame Trinka for her support. Lucy Gunning. Lucy is hoping to pursue a career working with children. Her plan is to move to the UK to go to college and from there travel around Europe. Lucy would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers, especially Ms. Jenner. Lucy is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Lucy. Michael Hamaguchi. Michael is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He will be attending UBC Okanagan to study nursing this fall. Michael would like to thank his friends and family for their support and his teachers for their hard work. Michael is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Michael. Maya Hemlock. Maya intends to continue her education in post-secondary to pursue a career as an elementary school teacher. She would like to thank her friends and family for their support, but especially Matthew, Lucy, and her dog, Remy. Maya is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Maya is also receiving the Outstanding Citizenship Award, which is presented to a student who is kind, inclusive, respectful, empathetic, and ethical. This student shows a strong sense of community-mindedness and personal accountability, and is able to work towards an ideal future in the world. As well, Maya is receiving the Outstanding Senior Perseverance Award. This award is presented to a student who serves as an exemplary model of perseverance to others in that they demonstrate excellence in the ability to continually work hard towards a goal, even when it would have been easier to quit. Maya is also the recipient of the prestigious $40,000 BD Luminaries Scholarship. She's going to be here for a minute. In addition, Maya has been chosen to receive a Truth and Reconciliation Commission and Racial Awareness Scholarship for $500. Here to present this scholarship is Curtis Joe Miller. And Maya is also the recipient of a $1,000 bursary from Delta Youth Support Links Society. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Abel. Congratulations, Maya. Bradley Hanna. Bradley is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies in the aviation industry. Rahan Hargan. Rahan will be taking a year off of school and later pursue a career as a sound engineer. He would like to thank his family, friends who supported him throughout the years, and he would also love to give a big shout out to Mr. Sekhan for motivating and pushing him to reach his goals. Andrew Hart. Andrew will be starting work in the plumbing industry in the fall. He also plans on enrolling at BCIT in the new year to attend the plumbing apprenticeship program. Andrew would like to thank his parents for supporting him through his high school years. Olivia Hayes. Olivia is going to take a break and explore her interests. She wishes to thank the teachers who made her high school experience better. Congratulations, Olivia. Yeah.
The next presenter this evening is Mr. Nettinger.
Sylvie Hoffman. Sylvie is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. She plans to study psychology at KPU before pursuing an electro-neurophysiologist technologist certification at BCIT. Sylvie would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for their support. Sylvie is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. She is also receiving the Outstanding Scholar Award, which is presented to a student who has maintained outstanding scholastic achievement throughout their Burnsview years. As well, Sylvie is the winner of a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Fine Arts. Congratulations, Sylvie. Mackenzie Hopkins. Mackenzie is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She is planning to take a year off after graduation while working towards becoming a firefighter. Mackenzie would like to thank her amazing strategies teachers as well as her parents for getting her to where she is now. Good luck to all the grads of 2022, and if you take a gap year, don't make it a gap life. Mackenzie is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Mackenzie. Devin Huang. Devin will be attending the University of British Columbia to pursue a degree in computer engineering. He would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers, especially Storm and Norman for helping him find his passion through robotics. Devin is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. He is also receiving the Senior Robotics Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Devin is a recipient of a $500 Higher Learning Scholarship. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Martinick. Devin is also the winner of a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Applied Design Skills and Technology. Congratulations, Devin. Matteo Imperatore. Matteo will continue his studies in Italy, where he will graduate from high school again. He would like to thank his family, his host family, and friends for this beautiful experience. Dawson Inkster. Dawson is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He will be attending Lesley College in September. Dawson would like to thank Mr. Ma and the rest of the Burnsview staff for helping him through high school. Dawson is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics. He is also the recipient of the Outstanding Senior Male Athlete Award, which is given to a male athlete who demonstrates outstanding athletic ability, sportsmanship, and leadership. Congratulations, Dawson. Abby Irwin. After graduation, Abby has plans to take the NCSA CPT course in the fall. She would like to thank her mom for the constant support, Ms. Jenner for always radiating positive energy, and whoever created copy and paste. Quote, I can't believe I had to take PE10 online for this. Abby is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Abby. Shahed Ismail. After graduation, Shahed is going to spend the summer working to save money as she will be starting her paralegal studies at VCC in September. Shahed would like to thank her parents for their support and her friends for all their help. Brendan Jeet. Brendan will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University in the fall, studying in the Health Sciences Department. He would like to thank his family, friends, and the ones who matter the most to him. Daniel Jarrett. Daniel will be attending BCIT in the fall, studying mechanical engineering. He would like to thank his friends, parents, and teachers for putting up with him over the past 5 years. Probably longer for your parents, though, right? And making everything possible. Daniel is a recipient of a $500 Delta Firefighter Scholarship. Here to present the scholarship is Mr. Pham. Congratulations, Daniel. Amelia Jez. Amelia is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University and would like to thank her teachers, parents, and friends for their support. Congratulations. Haven Jin. Haven is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual Dogwood diploma. After graduation, she plans to pursue animal biology at UBC to become a veterinarian. She would like to thank her friends for being there for her throughout high school and Mrs. Cheng for all of her guidance. Haven is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. She is also receiving a Bronze School Service Award for her commitment to helping within the Burnsview community. Haven has been awarded a $1,500 bursary from Branch 61 of the Royal Canadian Legion. Haven is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in fine arts. Congratulations, Haven. Saya Johal. Saya is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending the University of Victoria, continuing her education in psychology and human kinetics to become a sports psychologist. She will also be continuing towards her goal of becoming a pilot with the Canadian Air Force. She would like to thank her key support systems, which include her family and the Burnsview PE department, for helping her get through the past 5 years. Saya is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. As well, Saya is a recipient of the $500 South Delta Minor Hockey Association's Tim Jardine Scholarship. She is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Saya. Emerald Judge. Emerald will be attending the University of British Columbia, Okanagan for a Bachelor of Science degree. She would like to thank her parents, friends, and teachers for their continuous support. Admiral is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Admiral is also the recipient of a $1,000 bursary from Delta Youth Support Link Society. Here to present this scholarship is Mr. Pham. Congratulations, Admiral. Balreet Judge. Balreet will be attending the University of Fraser Valley in the spring, where she will be completing her Bachelor of Science in Nursing. She would like to thank her parents, friends, and teachers for their support. Balreet is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Balreet is also the recipient of a $1,000 scholarship from the North Rotary Club. Here to present the scholarship are Alex and Carolyn Ovies. Congratulations, Balreet. Prabdeep Kaur. Prabdeep is taking a short break to travel and work, then going to KPU to study criminology. She wants to thank her parents, relatives, and friends for their unconditional support and love. Congratulations to the 2022 graduating class. Best wishes for the future to all of you. Congratulations. Our next presenter is Ms. Dandewal.
Sahej Kaur. Sahej will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University in the fall studying criminology. She would like to thank her parents for their support and for always being there for her. Colby Q. After graduation, Colby is planning to travel. He would like to thank his family for their support over the years. Harneet Kayla. Harneet will be attending Douglas College in the fall for the Future Teachers Program. She is hoping to become an elementary school teacher. Harneet would like to thank her friends, family, teachers, and administrators for supporting her throughout the years and getting her through tough times. Harneet is the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in community service. Congratulations, Harneet. Mackenzie King. Mackenzie is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual Dogwood diploma. She plans to continue her education at University of Victoria in the Recreation and Health Education Program. She would like to thank her parents and teachers for supporting her. Mackenzie is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Mackenzie is also the recipient of a $200 scholarship from PAC at Richardson Elementary. Here to present the scholarship is Miss Bai. As well, Mackenzie is the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Mackenzie. Cushy Claire. Cushy is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending the University of the Fraser Valley, pursuing a degree in sciences. Cushy would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for their guidance and support. Amina Katua. After graduation, Amina is going to be studying to accomplish her dream to be a dentist. She would like to thank Ms. Winnick, Ms. Forbes, and Ms. Jenner, who supported her through thick and thin. During her school years, Amina learned, whoever wants knowledge is present inside or outside the school. But the most important thing is that you decide what you want to do. Ananthbir Gular. Ananth will be pursuing his goals next year. He would like to give a special thanks to his aunt and uncle for raising him, and a special thanks to the friends he made throughout the last few years. Prabhavir Lahal. Prabhavir will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University to receive a bachelor's degree in accounting. He would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for their support over the last few years. Prabhavir is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. Well done, Prabhavir. Jasmine Lepore. Jasmine will be attending Douglas College in the fall to study psychology. She is planning on becoming a counselor. Jasmine would like to thank her family and friends for the support they have given her throughout high school. Jasmine is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Jasmine. Ashley Leung. Ashley will be studying at the University of Toronto this fall to achieve her dream of becoming an orthodontist. She would like to thank, it's on the other page, all her teachers and peers for making the last few years an unforgettable experience. Ashley is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics as well as Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. She is also the recipient of the Graphic Design Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Congratulations, Ashley. Nathan Lightfoot. After graduation, Nathan plans to work and travel for a year before continuing his education. He would like to thank his friends and family who have supported him throughout his high school experience. Nathan is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Nathan. Matthias Lindahl. Matthias is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood. This fall, he will be attending the Journey Program at BCIT. Matthias would like to thank his family, friends, teachers for helping him to discover his passion. Matthias is the recipient of the Senior Information Technology Specialty Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. He is also receiving the Senior Woodwork Tech Ed Specialty Award. Well done. Matthias is also the recipient of a 1,000 trade scholarship from the North Delta Rotary Club. Here to present the scholarship is Alex and Caroline Ovies. Congratulations, Matthias. Mario Lopez. Mario will be attending BCIT for the automotive refinishing program. He would like to thank his mom and dad for all their love and support and his friends for the good times. Blake McCory. Blake is receiving a dual dogwood diploma and DELF certificate from the French Immersion Program. He plans to continue his studies at Douglas College while also playing on their soccer team. Blake would like to extend a big thank you to all of his friends, family, and teachers who helped him along the way towards graduation. Blake is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. Well done, Blake. The next presenter is Miss Baya.
Hamad Mahmoud. After high school, Hamad plans on going to Bow Valley College to finish his two academic courses he needs. Then Hamad plans to take a year off to work and focus on his religion, and depending from there, he'll see what to do next. Hamad would like to thank parents, brothers, and friends who helped him get through high school. Jeremy Malin. After graduation, Jeremy would like to travel around the world before continuing on to post-secondary. He would like to thank first and foremost his friends from theater, teachers, and family that support him. Jeremy is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. He is also receiving of a senior drama award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Congratulations, Jeremy. Rajveer Mann. Rajveer will be attending KPU in the fall, studying computer science based on a Java developer. He would like to thank his teachers and parents for all the love and support he got from them throughout the years he has been at Burnsview. A special thank you to Ms. Baya and Ms. Mann. Alberta Marchiori. Alberta will be returning to Italy and completing high school. He wishes to pursue further schooling in human sciences. Alberto would like to thank his family and homestay family for this opportunity to live grade 12 twice. Alberto is the recipient of the Senior Food Studies Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Well done, Alberto. Angela Margaritis. Angela is planning on attending the UBC of Okanagan, continuing her studies in science. She would like to thank her family and friends for the support over her high school experience. Matthew McPherson. Matthew is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies to pursue a career in international relations. Matthew would like to thank his parents and his family, as well as Maya, Daniel, Michael, Noah, and Brad for always being there for him. Matthew is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. He's also the recipient of a $750 scholarship from the North Delta Minor Hockey Association. Here to present this scholarship is the president of the North Delta Minor Hockey Association, Rob Reed. Congratulations, Matthew. Kai Mearns. After graduation, Kai plans to go to post-secondary to study kinesiology and join the wrestling team. He would like to thank all the teachers, his friends, and his family that supported him and turned him into the man he is today. And he can bench 285. Carla Majerito. After high school, Carla plans on taking time off school to work. She will then be attending Vancouver Community College to pursue a career as a pharmacy technician. Carla would like to thank her mom and friends for their support throughout the years. Carla is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. She is also receiving the Senior Textiles Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Congratulations, Carla. Sam Mahajczak. Sam will be taking a year off to explore the arts in all its forms, followed by a plan for post-secondary in theater. They would like to thank their parents for constantly pushing them to elaborate, their teachers for helping them to open up, and for shining in a light on their true love and passion, all things theater. Looking at you, Miss Stark, they wouldn't be here without all of you. Lauren Moore. Lauren is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending KPU for psychology. Lauren would like to thank her family for their support and encouragement. Lauren is also the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in community service. Congratulations, Lauren. Matthew Mortine. Matthew is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He plans on continuing his studies at Douglas College in the Sports Science Program. Matthew would like to thank his friends and family that helped him throughout his time in high school. Amber Nadim. Amber will be attending the University of British Columbia in the fall and will be studying political science. She wants to thank God and her friends and family for helping her get where she is, with a special shout out to her mom, who has been the backbone of all her achievements and has shown her what it means to never give up, even in times of despair. Be peaceful, be courteous. Malcolm X. Umber is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. As well, Umber is the recipient of a $1,000 bursary from Delta Youth Support Link Society. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Stark. Congratulations, Umber. Ishan Naeem. After graduation, Ishan will be attending a four-year bachelor's degree program for cybersecurity at BCIT. He would like to thank his friends and his family for their continuous and overwhelming support. Jaisal Nair. After graduation, Jason will be attending the University of Victoria. He would like to thank his friends and family for supporting him throughout the years, as well as his teachers and coaches. Jason is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. He's also the recipient of a 250 Laura Strendel Memorial Scholarship. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Samra. Congratulations, Jason. The next presenter is Ms. Mann.
Liam Nielsen Anderson. Liam will be attending BCIT in the fall, where he will be enrolled in the Electrical Foundations program to fulfill his goal to become an electrician. He would like to thank his parents and teachers for all the support and help over the years. Sydney Nielsen Anderson. Sydney is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending Thompson River University in the fall for a Bachelor's of Arts degree, which will help her achieve her goal of becoming a teacher. She would like to thank her parents for their constant love and support, as well as her friends and family. Georgia Newworth. Georgia is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual Dogwood diploma. They will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University to fine arts and broaden their artistic abilities. Georgia would like to thank their family and friends for always supporting them along the way. Bhavan Nidger. Bhavan will be attending BCIT in September of this year for a diploma in accounting. Ludovica Occupanti. Ludovica made her dreams come true here at Burnsview, where she attended her exchange year program. Upon her return to Italy, she will continue her scientific studies in order to get a high school degree there. She may come back to Canada to attend university. Ludovica wants to thank her teachers, in particular Miss Yang, her host family for making her feel at home, her family and friends for supporting and encouraging her during this wonderful adventure. Ludovica is also the recipient of an Outstanding Achievement in Academics Award. Congratulations, Ludovica. Alexandra Ocarino. Alexander is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He will be attending school at the University of Victoria, studying general sciences. Alexander is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics. Well done, Alexander. Nicholas Oreskovic. Nick is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual Dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies at LaSalle College in the program. Nick would like to thank his friends because he wouldn't be here without them. Rebecca Osborne. Rebecca is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be continuing her studies at Douglas College to study psychology. Rebecca would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for pushing her to do her best. Khalil Othman. Khalil will be taking a break from school for a year to work and save money. He will also be taking some additional courses that he needs. Khalil would like to give a big thank you to Ms. Naveen for helping him throughout high school, and thank you to my family for the support as well. Sharia Barik. Sharia is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She will be attending the University of British Columbia in the Faculty of Science. Sharia would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers for their motivation, support, and guidance throughout her high school journey. Sharia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Sharia. Jasmine Parmar. Jasmine will be attending BCC in the fall, where she will be studying dental hygiene. Jasmine is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Jasmine. Emily Pavlonis. Emily will be studying business in post-secondary. She would like to thank her host family, friends, and teachers for their support. Emily is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Emily. Amani Pawar. After graduation, Amani will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University, studying to obtain a degree in accounting. She will then continue her studies in law. Amani would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for the guidance and support. Amani is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Amani. The next presenter is Mr. Pham.
Thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Pham.
All right, Thao Phan. After graduation, Thao will return to Vietnam. She plans to continue her studies at one of the international universities in the International Business Program. She also has plans to travel to countries in Europe. Thao would like to thank her friends, teachers, homestay family, and especially her parents for their continuous support. Micah Piva. Micah is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. Next year, he will be going to KPU to pursue civil engineering. Micah would like to thank Mr. Ma for everything he has done, and most of all, for being awesome. Micah is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics. Congratulations, Micah. Akito Prefontaine. Aki is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He plans to study archaeology at UBC in the fall. Aki would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for their support. Akito is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Akito. Kage Prefontaine. Kage is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. He will be attending UBC Vancouver to study kinesiology. Kage would like to thank his family, friends, coaches, and teachers for supporting him throughout the years. Kage is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics. Also, Kage is also a winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Kage. Sonia Perwell. After graduation, Sonia will be attending Simon Fraser, studying sustainable energy engineering. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for their guidance and support. Sonia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics. As well, Sonia has been awarded a $1,000 scholarship from the Educational Facility Managers Association of BC Zone 4, Lower Mainland. Here to present this scholarship to Zone by the Zone Chair, Jose Paleo, from School District Number 38, Richmond. Congratulations, Sonia. Ethan Quinn. Ethan would like to thank his parents, family, and friends for helping and supporting him throughout the years. Congratulations, grads of 2022. Insta Raja. Insta will be attending Jamia Ahmadiyya Canada in Maple, Ontario in the fall to pursue a career as an Ahmadi Muslim scholar. Firstly, he would like to thank Allah for giving him the best blessed opportunity to be where he is currently. He would also like to thank all the teachers who helped him along the journey. Lastly, he would like to thank his parents for being by his side. Insa is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. Well done, Insa. Abish Rajendran. Abish will continue his education while volunteering and working part-time with his dad. He is interested in obtaining a Bachelor of Science in Applied Mathematics. He would like to thank his family for continuous support. Anisha Rakra. Anisha will be attending BCIT full-time in the fall, where she will be studying architecture to fulfill her dream of becoming an architect. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for helping her to get to where she is today. As well, a special shout out to her sister for being a free tutor. Anisha is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Anisha is also a recipient of a $380 scholarship for the Sunshine Hills Tennis Club. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Martinique. Congratulations, Anisha. Olivia Rumlu. Olivia is receiving a dual double dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. Olivia is going to KPU in the fall before going to the veterinary school in Saskatchewan. She would like to thank her mother for being her best friend and number one supporter, and without whom she would not be where she is today. Olivia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Olivia. Catherine Rector. Catherine is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual Dogwood diploma. She plans to attend Douglas College to pursue physiotherapy next year. Catherine would like to thank her family for their support, her friends for making school fun, and her teachers for all their hard work. She would like to thank her dog, Patty, for always being awesome. Catherine is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. As well, Catherine is the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Catherine. Trinity Robinson. Trinity is receiving a dual Dogwood diploma from French Immersion Program. She plans to travel and work for a year before continuing her education in psychology. Trinity would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for leading her towards success in life. Trinity is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Trinity. Sheldon Rodriguez. Following his passion for all things mechanical, Sheldon will be continuing his career as an automotive service technician in order to receive his Red Seal certificate. He would like to thank Mr. Ma for encouraging him to follow his dreams, as well as Mrs. Forbes for always being real to him, with him. He could not have done it without the support from his family and friends. Sheldon is the recipient of an award for an outstanding achievement in academics. Sheldon is also the recipient of a $200 scholarship from Glacier Media. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Martinuk. And one more as well. Sheldon is the winner of a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Technical and Trades Training. Congratulations, Sheldon. Vincent Rodriguez. After graduation, Vincent will continue to pursue his trade and work to get his ticket, but has not closed his options to other things. He would like to thank his mom and dad, along with his sister, for supporting him through his high school journey. He wishes his classmates the best of luck in life. And the next presenter is Mr. Butler.
Max Russell. Max is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies at Douglas College in the General Business Program. Matt would like to thank his family for all their support they gave him. Matt is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Matt. Madison Ryan. Madison is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. He will be taking a year to make money, travel, and acquire work experience before continuing his education. Madison would like to thank family, friends, and teachers for guiding him on his journey out into the working world. Verinda Sabatha. After graduation, Verinda will be attending University of British Columbia, where she will be studying applied animal biology. She would like to thank her parents and her friends and congratulate the graduates of 2022. Verinda is the recipient of an award for an outstanding achievement in academics. As well, Verinda has been selected to receive a $1,000 BC School Superintendents Association scholarship. She is also the recipient of the $1,000 Beverly Barnes Memorial Scholarship. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Samra. Congratulations, Verinda. Asisvir Sahansawal. After graduation, Asus will be attending the Bachelor's of Science program at UBC and plans on continuing his education through med school. He would like to thank his teachers and his friends for their continued support, but most of all his parents for their immense inspiration. Asus is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and athletics, as well as a scholarship achievement award of distinction. Well done. Asus is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in community service. Congratulations, Asusvir. Tasnim Saeed. After graduation, Tasnim plans to continue on to college in the nursing program. Tasnim would like to thank her friends, teachers, and especially her parents who have supported her through her studies. Amrinder Saini. Amrinder will continue his education at Kwantlen Polytechnic University for criminology with aspirations of working in the justice field. He would like to thank his teachers, friends, and family for the constant support and guidance throughout these many years. Amrinder is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in athletics. Well done, Amrinder. Estella Salinas. After a long and grueling 5 years of high school, Estella is finally graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. She'll be attending KPU in the fall, where she'll be studying graphic design for marketing. Estella would like to thank her parents for always supporting her dreams and goals. Estella is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Estella. Peyton Sammy. Yeah. After graduation, Peyton plans on continuing his education and pursuing a career in finances. Peyton would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for all their support. Peyton is the recipient of a $750 scholarship from the North Delta Minor Hockey Association. Here to present this scholarship is the president of the North Delta Minor Hockey Association, Rob Reed. Congratulations, Peyton. Pavneet Sanger. Pavneet is looking forward to pursuing her career in criminology. She would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers for helping her become the person she is today. Brad Sonia. Brad is graduating with many friends and memories that have been made along the way. He would like to thank his friends and family who have supported throughout. Brad would also like to say a special thank you to Mrs. Trinka and Ms. Kay for their tremendous help during high school. Kalia Sayer. Kalia will be taking a year off from school to work and will be attending post-secondary in the fall of 2023. She would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers for all their support over the years. Kalia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics and a scholarship achievement award of distinction. Congratulations, Kalia. Evan Schmidt. After graduation, Evan will be pursuing his career in automotive mechanics until he gets to a level 4 Red Seal mechanic. He would like to thank his parents and friends for always supporting him and helping him get where he is now. Isaiah Segura. Isaiah is graduating with a dual dogwood diploma in the French Immersion Program and will be attending BCIT for 3D modeling art and animation. Astra Sharma. Astra is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She'll be attending Simon Fraser University with the intention of studying history and political science. Astra would like to thank all her teachers for putting up with her and her friends' antics over these past 5 years. Astra has also been chosen to receive a Truth and Reconciliation Commission and Racial Awareness Scholarship for $500. Here to present this scholarship is Curtis Joe Miller. Congratulations, Astra. Rhea Sharma. After graduation, Rhea will be attending UBC Okanagan, where she'll be studying business. She would like to say a thank you to everyone who has supported her through her high school journey. The next presenter is Madam Sobetti.
Cheyenne Simicak.
Cheyenne is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. She will be continuing to play softball at UBC Okanagan and study in the Health and Exercise Sciences program. Cheyenne would like to thank her family and friends for their continuous support and helping her become who she is today. Cheyenne is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, and she is also the winner of a $1,250 district award for superior achievement in physical activity. Congratulations, Cheyenne. Ramanveer Singh. Following graduation, Ramanveer will be working towards his career goal of becoming a truck driver. Truck Chalona Ketchake. Taran Singh. After graduation, Taran is going to BCIT for the civil engineering program. He would like to thank his friends, family, and especially his parents who have supported him throughout his journey in high school. Taran is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Taran. Rudy Slatt. Rudy is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. Rudy plans to take a year off from schooling and will later pursue performing arts and fine arts with the goal of being a stage actor. Rudy is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. As well, Rudy is receiving the Renaissance Award, which recognizes a student's outstanding contributions to the fine and performing arts at BurnsU. Congratulations, Rudy. Felicity Slater. Felicity plans to take a gap year to work and then travel next summer. Her goal is to become a scuba diving pizza delivery man. She wants to thank Ms. Sorbetti for keeping her in line for her first 2 years at BurnsU and Dr. Neufeld for her last 2 years. Bridget Smalley. Bridget will be studying sciences at Simon Fraser University in the fall. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for supporting her and believing in her. Bridget is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievements in academics, as well as a Scholastic Achievement Award of Distinction. Bridget is also the recipient of a $500 scholarship from FYI Doctors Surrey. Here to present this scholarship is Mr. Butler. Congratulations, Bridget. Jamie Smiley. Jamie will be continuing her education in September in the Emergency Responders Program. She plans on working part-time as a paramedic while working towards her nursing degree. She would like to thank Ms. Kay, Curtis, and her family. Stay gold, class of 2022. Kelsey Snow. Kelsey is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. Kelsey will be attending Langara College in the fall and plans on becoming a neonatal nurse in the future. She would like to thank her parents and close friends for their support throughout the past years. Congratulations. Sahil Sokhi. After graduation, Sahil plans to continue studying his favorite subjects as he moves on to post-secondary. He would like to give huge thanks to his friends, family, and amazing teachers who shared unforgettable experiences and lessons throughout these years. Congratulations. Amelia St. Jean Roncourette. Amelia is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. She will be attending SFU this fall for the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences. Amelia would like to thank her family and friends for motivating her throughout high school. Amelia is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. As well, she is the recipient of a $250 scholarship from the PAC at Ecole Devon Gardens. Here to present this scholarship is Miss Baya. Congratulations, Amelia. Ella Stoughton. Ella will be receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She will be attending Kwantlen Polytechnic University in the fall, studying horticulture technology.
Ella would like to thank her friends and family for all the support to help her get her to where she is today. Congratulations. Nolan Stewart. Next year, Nolan will be going to UFV to pursue a Bachelor of Science. He wishes to thank all of his friends and family for getting him through high school and making these last 5 years enjoyable. Nolan is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievements in athletics. Well done, Nolan. Peyton Stutchberry. Peyton is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. She will be attending University of Victoria Faculty of Science next year. Peyton would like to thank her teachers, family, and friends for their support during her school years. Peyton is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Peyton. Tiana Sullivan. Tiana is graduating from the French Immersion Program, receiving a dual dogwood diploma. She will be taking a year off from school to work and will be attending post-secondary in the fall of 2023. She would like to thank her parents and teachers for all their support. Congratulations. Sumit Rathore. Sumit Rathore will be attending SFU for a Bachelor of Science after high school. He would like to thank his parents who encouraged him to not give up. Sumit is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. He is also the recipient of a $1,000 North Delta Lions Club scholarship. Here to present this scholarship is North Delta Lion Habir Batra. Congratulations, Sumit. The next presenter is Ms. Yang.
Mahib Tharu. Mahib will be attending UBC in the fall, majoring in psychology. He would like to thank his friends and teachers for their support throughout the years. Mahib is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. As well, Mahib is the recipient of a $500 bursary from Delta Youth Support Link Society. Here to present this scholarship is Ms. Dandiwal. Mahib is also the winner of a $1,000 scholarship from the Delta Community Foundation. He is also the recipient of the UBC Centennial Award. Congratulations, Mahib. Noah Thiessen. Noah plans to continue his studies at post-secondary institution this fall. He would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for all their support, especially Mr. Butler for making Chemistry 12 bearable. Noah is the recipient for an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Noah. Francisca Timothée. Francisca is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She plans to continue her studies at the University of Victoria in the engineering program. Francisca would like to thank her parents and friends for their support. Francisca is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Francisca. Yeah, Francisca! Russell Trepke. Russell is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a dual dogwood diploma. He plans to continue his studies at BCIT in the HVAC and refrigeration program. Russell would like to thank his parents for their encouragement and support. Russell is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Russell. Evie Trites. Evie is receiving a dual dogwood diploma from the French Immersion Program. She'll be taking a much-needed break next year. She would like to thank Ms. Kangara. Evie is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Evie. Jessica Ursua. Jessica will be attending LaSalle College in the fall, where she will be studying fashion and design to fulfill her dream of becoming a designer. She would like to thank her family, teachers, and friends, but especially her mother and Miss Jenner. Jessica is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as the Senior Textiles Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Jessica is also the recipient of a $500 Burnsview PAC scholarship. Here to present the scholarship is Mr. Butler. As well, Jessica has been chosen to receive a Truth and Reconciliation Commission and Racial Awareness Scholarship for $500. Here to present the scholarship is Curtis Miller Joe. Jessica is also the winner of a $1,250 District Award for Superior Achievement in Fine Arts. Congratulations, Jessica. Jenna Vowles. Jenna is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a Dual Dogwood Diploma. She will be attending the University of Alberta in the fall, where she will study kinesiology. Jenna would like to acknowledge her charismatic teachers for their support and a small number of immensely supportive friends who made this journey into adulthood so unforgettable and special. Jenna would like to deeply thank her parents for the endless amount of love during some of the toughest yet greatest years of her life. Jenna is a recipient for an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Well done, Jenna. Alexis Wagler. After graduation, Alexis is planning to attend Douglas College to further her education. She would like to thank her teachers, friends, and family for supporting her throughout high school. Alexis is the recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Alexis. Chloe Warwick. Chloe is receiving a Dual Dogwood Diploma from the French Immersion Program. She is attending both Douglas College and SFU in the fall to complete a degree in criminology. Chloe would like to thank her best friends for putting up with her throughout all of high school. Chloe is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics, as well as a Senior Film and Video Award for displaying outstanding achievement in that area. Well done, Chloe. Julia Weiss. Julia is going back to Europe and will be studying circular engineering in the Netherlands. She would like to thank her parents, her home safe family, and friends for these three unexpected years at Burnsview. Julia is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Julia. Sophia Wingate. Sophia is graduating from the French Immersion Program with a Dual Dogwood Diploma. She plans to study biology at university in the fall. She's deeply thankful to her family and teachers for their continued support, as well as her friends for all of their irreplaceable memories. Sophia is a recipient of an award for outstanding achievement in academics. Congratulations, Sophia. Yankee Wong. Yankee will be attending university in Vancouver studying business. He would like to thank his parents for always supporting and encouraging him, and his friends for their company and concern for him. Alicia Woodward. After graduation, Alicia plans to take a gap year to travel and work as a veterinary assistant. I will now turn the program back over to Mr. Richards.
Je vous présente M. Richards, directeur adjoint, qui va présenter le gagnant du Griffin Cup pour 2021-22.
We will now welcome Vice Principal Mr. Richards, who will introduce the winner of the Griffin Cup for 2022.
Thank you. Selection of the outstanding senior student, the Griffin Cup Award, occurs through a staff nomination process, then presentation of evidence as to why the student should be selected. Nominees are narrowed down and discussions take place to determine which student is most deserving of the award. Criteria for outstanding senior student encompasses outstanding effort and achievement in a variety of aspects of school life, including but not limited to scholastic achievement, service, citizenship, and athletics. This year, as in the past, when selecting our outstanding senior student, many well-deserving students were nominated. After staff discussions, it was evident one student populated everyone's list. This student's academic achievements, citizenship, service, and athletic involvement at BurnsU is viewed as exceptional. This student promotes inclusion and equity by being respectful and accepting of others. This student is passionate about societal issues, consistently contributing to the social, emotional, and intellectual learning community at BurnsU. Our Griffin Cup Award winner is a thoroughly outstanding person who is involved at BurnsU on many levels. This student is conscientious and articulate, and a team player who makes meaningful contributions in all classes. Always curious and thoughtful, this student is not only committed to their own success, but the success of peers as well. With maturity and diligence and having to adapt their graduation years to a global pandemic, this student conducted herself throughout this school year with dignity, compassion, and a thoughtfulness that encompasses the spirit of the Griffin Cup Award. This year's outstanding senior student is Emily Bancroft. Emily, come on down. Now Emily gets to stand and listen. Emily works hard academically and dedicates herself to achieving her personal best in all areas of work. Over her secondary school year, she consistently earned a G award for exemplary work habits. She will receive her dual Dogwood diploma this year. Furthermore, Emily maintained principal's list standing and earned over 90% in all her courses at BurnsU every year. In addition to Emily's strong work habits and scholastic achievement, her positive attitude has always helped her achieve excellence. Emily's teachers all responded that she is a pleasure to have in class, and her cheerful and upbeat nature makes learning easy for her and a pleasure for Emily to be in their classes. Emily proves herself through her excellent research skills, her energetic presentation skills, and her maturity. She consistently exceeds project requirements and the work of her peers. Her curious nature, high level of engagement, and critical nature make her a born leader and the perfect recipient of this award. Emily is not only a leader academically, she also excels with community and school leadership skills as well. She has been involved in many BurnsU extracurricular activities, participating on various sports teams as an athlete, and volunteering her time to support the yearbook. She is an organizer, scorekeeper, picture taker, leader, and completes a multitude of other tasks. Within these capacities, she maintains a mature and friendly attitude, committed to the task at hand, and manages her time effectively. Emily has been an integral part of BurnsU's graphic production team, supporting the production of the school's outstanding and amazing yearbook. Emily's positive and encouraging nature are consistently displayed in everything she does. One staff member provided the following information regarding Emily that I have to share. She stated, "Emily is a one-of-a-kind sort of student who comes along and literally shines. Her attitude in class is positive, endearing, engaging, dedicated, and a little sassy. As a leader, Emily takes charge of multiple projects and works effectively with her peers in a supportive manner that speaks volumes to her maturity and kindness to treat others with respect. Her greatest growth has been as a person. The biggest lesson Emily has learned is to listen. not just to her mentors, teachers, and advisors, but to the people around her, gaining insight and perspective from others' points of view. As an editor for the yearbook, Emily took on a difficult position of having to be the liaison for her grad class and be the editor as well. She performed both roles seamlessly. As a peer and leader, Emily learned to listen to the ideas of her peers and take their voices into consideration. This position helped Emily develop skills in patience, organization, and communication. All of these activities illuminate Emily's responsible and reliable character. We have regularly witnessed Emily taking time to work and support others to ensure their success and happiness before her own. Emily is well respected by her peers, teachers, and the administration for her kind, caring, and outgoing personality. Her service, citizenship, academic achievement, and engagement within the school has been prodigious. Please join me in congratulating Emily Bancroft as Burnsview's outstanding senior student and Griffin A Cup Award winner.
Sarah Jahal va nous présenter le discours d'adieu.
And now we will welcome valedictorian Saya Johal to the stage.
If I could get everybody to rise for a moment, please. Yeah, and you guys can just like stretch. I know we've been here for a while, so just like, you know, get comfy. Okay, everybody all stretched out? Okay, you guys can sit back down now. Good evening, parents, teachers, and my fellow graduates. It is a great honor to be given this responsibility by my peers and be standing before you as Burnsview's 2022 valedictorian. I would like to acknowledge that we are on the unceded territory of the Musqueam and Coast Salish First Nations peoples. J'aimerais reconnaître que nous nous trouvons sur le territoire non cédé des Premières Nations Musqueam et Coast Salish. We as a class are so happy that we get to celebrate this occasion with you all in person after a difficult couple of years. It's no secret to all of us that we have endured an extremely unlucky last 3 years of high school and life in general. Nobody predicted that we would leave for spring break in grade 10 and not fully return for a regular year of school until our senior year. Even through online school, a quarter system and being restricted to specific learning cohorts, then being introduced to a semester system, we're finally here. We made it to graduation. But let's backtrack a few years to when it all started in September of 2017, when we were those little grade eights who stopped in the middle of the hall for no reason and walked so extremely slow in little herds. We got lost in the halls like they were the changing staircases at Hogwarts, but then quickly figured out that there's really only four possible hallways you can walk down. Nous sommes tous entrés dans le nouveau monde de l'école secondaire avec tant à apprendre et avec des possibilités infinies de qui nous pourrions être. Nous nous sommes donné de grands objectifs à atteindre une fois que nous avons découvert toutes les possibilités. Then we entered our junior year, and it started off great. Mr. Ma was leading his boys' volleyball team to yet another victory, and Mr. Massey was baking cookies with his girls' basketball team. This was when our grade 10 year unfortunately got cut short. We left for spring break, the pandemic struck, and the whole world changed. This caused a whole new way of learning and living. The times of COVID-19 were a learning experience for everyone. Both the teachers and students had to learn new systems and were faced with many different challenges. I could go on about life in quarantine, the struggles we endured, the restrictions that were set, and how everyone actually turned off their Zoom cameras and slept during class. Instead, I'm going to tell you something I was once told, which I feel highly resonates with our class. You can look at it as a glass half empty or half full. We can look at it as a glass half empty, where we focus on the negative aspects, such as missing out, or as a glass half full, where we focus on the more positive aspects that came about, such as discovering our strengths individually and as a collective. L'année dernière a commencé comme les autres, mais a été écourtée à cause de la pandémie. Nous avons tous dû apprendre de nouveaux systèmes et adapter nos modes de vie. Je pourrais continuer à parler des expériences que nous avons vécues, mais je vais plutôt souligner les aspects positifs qui sont venus de cette situation. I firmly believe that the reason we are able to be here today is because we as a Burnsview community did not give up. We saw the teachers and students come together and learn from each other, which made us stronger. This is why all of the worries of what our final high school year would look like all went away soon after we entered our senior year. I'll give you a short glimpse into what it ended up looking like. It looked like learning not to make people crowd surf on a boat. It looked like winning another banner to proudly hang in the gym. It looked like joyrides on golf carts. It looked like Miss K having very choice words about her missing clock and using her water gun to relay the message. It looked like one girl out of 18 boys who tied up a quarterfinal game. And it looked like all of us mysteriously missing on a random Thursday. Notre communauté s'est réunie et nous avons vu les enseignants et les élèves apprendre les uns des autres et nous avons découvert des forces, ensemble et individuellement. Je crois que c'est la raison pour laquelle nous pouvons tous être ici ensemble aujourd'hui. Je me souviens qu'après la 11e année, je me demandais ce qui nous attendait pour notre dernière année. À la fin, c'était tout ce que nous avons imaginé quand nous avons commencé le lycée, ou même plus. Nous nous sommes fait tellement de souvenirs au long de cette année que nous nous gardons pour toujours. With our grade 12 year coming to a close, we will always remember the fun, but there will also be so much to learn. None of us would be here today if it weren't for our teachers and the lessons they've taught us. Yes, they've taught us the textbook things, but they've also given us the tools we're going to need as we enter the real world. They've guided us from little grade eights to the young adults we have become, and they are the inspiration for who we wish to become. We all hope that you know we are so incredibly thankful for each and every one of you and all the hard work you put in. As for myself, I can't take all the credit for my being up here. Ms. Kugel and Madame Marshick, you are two of the most encouraging and kind-hearted people who were thoughtful enough to help me in the writing of the speech. Ms. Chang and Mr. Butler, you are two of the most patient individuals, which is a hard thing to be when you're dealing with grade 12s 24/7, and without whom none of our grad events would have been possible. Finally, Ms. Bai and Mr. Burford, to say you are the people I look up to most would be an understatement. You are my biggest role models, and I can only hope to become half the people you are. Aujourd'hui, nous nous rendons compte que tout nous devons tout à nos enseignants. Vous nous avez donné les conseils nécessaires pour nous rendre ici et nous avons appris des choses que nous partons avec dans notre vie d'adulte. Nous apprécions tout ce que vous avez fait pour que nous réussissions. We've hit the milestone of graduating, but this is the first step into our futures. So as we leave here today, I don't think we should be sad. I think we should be thankful. Thankful for all the friendships and all the memories. Say goodbye to our times as Griffins and look forward with excitement into the future. Merci.
Je vous présente M. Richards qui aimerait offrir quelques mots aux finissants.
We will now welcome Vice Principal Mr. Richards back to the stage for some final words to the graduates.
We're almost done. I would like to thank Burnsview's graduating class of 2022. Congratulations. Parents, guardians, families, and friends, for an amazing and wonderful graduation experience. It has been amazing and extraordinary to do this live, in person, and without retakes. As Mr. Younger has mentioned multiple times, your graduating class will reflect in future years on how much you have had to adapt and change, conform to health and safety requirements, and start and pause your education multiple times. Your education and learning has been impacted, shaped, and redesigned, and pedagogy must evolve and keep up with the enormity of changes and transformations. However, I strongly believe this graduating class will be successful in whatever the world chooses to throw your way. If you can survive your high school experience during a 2.5-year world pandemic, then you can face any challenge and have success. Thank you, graduates, for your strength and courage as you have navigated learning during some very difficult times. Before ending our ceremony today, there are a number of thank yous in order. Without these volunteers dedicating hours of their time, this event would not have been such a success. First and foremost, Burnsview's amazing administrative office staff need to be thanked. Ms. Little, Ms. Hare, Ms. Wong, and Ms. Jorgensen, thank you for your hard work in putting the final touches together to make this event a success. Ms. Cheng, thank you for accepting and organizing all the grad quotes, being a leader for grad committee, and leading the work on scholarships. Mr. Butler, thank you for your time organizing the grad committee and supporting with the ceremony. Ms. Scheibel, thank you for organizing the staff and all the finer details associated with this ceremony. Madame Trinka and Ms. Stark, thank you for being the masters of ceremony and providing a smooth flow to the evening. The Burnsview staff here tonight, reading for and organizing students, thank you for your support. Thank you, Mr. Kanakis and Mr. Bauman, for your greetings and address to the graduates. And finally, Mr. Younger, thank you for your countless hours of planning, driving, picking up, and organizing for an event like this. Thank you for your dedication to this graduating class. To Burnsview's graduating class of 2022, we wish you all the success in your future endeavors. Thank you for being an amazing graduating class. Now before we leave, Saya, can you come back please?
If my classmates could now make their way to the stage following the instruction of their teachers, you guys can come down now.
Is everyone gonna do it?
Yeah, everyone has to.
Okay. Is there one of the Okay. When we toss our hats, this signifies the end of our times as high schoolers and the start of our adult lives. Whatever's in store for us in the future, I have no doubt that we as individuals will make it through. Regardless of where we end up or who we become, once a Griffin, always a Griffin. So without further ado, it is my pleasure to present to you, one final time, BurnsU's graduating class of 2022.
Sorry. Mm-hmm.